Hi everyone, my name is Nick, and this week's plant of the week is Philodendron gloriosum. The name really says it all with this houseplant. These leaves are truly stunning, and this plant is really overall just such a show-stopping work of art. This plant is native to Colombia, and it is a member of the Araceae family, so it's classified as an aroid and is very closely related to many other plants, such as Raphidophora, Monstera, Aglaonema, Spathiphyllum, and the like. However, this philodendron particularly has gained a lot of popularity over the last couple of years, which is definitely warranted because, like I was saying, these leaves are truly gorgeous. The white veins are practically luminescent amongst the matte green leaves, so it's totally understandable why this plant has gained so much popularity. But I also think it's kind of funny because it's a plant that prior to the last couple of years, or still in the last couple of years, but mainly prior to the last couple of years, was mainly used as a landscaping houseplant. So this is very similar to some other philodendrons such as Philodendron Burl Marx and Philodendron Gigantum, where if you're in a more tropical climate, say if you live or visiting Florida in the United States, this is a plant that you're often going to see used in landscaping displays outside, probably more commonly in more developed areas, but it's something that you will definitely be seeing. So I think that's quite phenomenal how a plant that has really become a hot commodity is still something that you might just see in run-of-the-mill displays if you're in like Miami or Orlando. So just something to note there, which I think is kind of fun. But even as this houseplant has gained more popularity, gone up in price, and become a little bit more elusive over the years, rest assured if you do get your hands on this houseplant, it is a very easy and rewarding one to grow. So I've had this one in my possession for a couple of years now. I probably got this in like 2017, 2018, and I purchased it as a small 4-inch pot of plant, just a little plastic 4-inch nursery pot that you would typically see if you go into a houseplant store. I think there was just one or two little plants in this pot, maybe just like two or three leaves at the time. And this thing has exploded into this large plant that's literally pushing me off screen today. So the light for this houseplant is pretty straightforward as far as philodendrons go. This is just like many other philodendrons that fall into that middle of the road area of the spectrum where they want that indirect light, bright indirect light, but no direct sunlight whatsoever. As where this is growing in its native habitat, it's just kind of creeping along the forest floor and it's not receiving any direct sunlight, sun rays whatsoever. It's just getting hit with some dappled sunlight every now and again. So you can try to replicate that in your home. So the watering with this houseplant is not necessarily difficult at all. It's a little bit more, it enjoys water a little bit more than some other philodendrons. So I do find myself keeping this on the more moist side, where many other philodendrons I will let dry out pretty much like 50-75% of the way before I go ahead and give them a drink. This one I'm probably watering a little bit more often. And a tip that I've learned on social media to kind of combat that with this plant is to use some sphagnum moss in the soil. So while I'm still using a typical aroid mix, like potting mixture, peat based or coconut based, with some perlite and some charcoal and some orchid bark is what I'm typically using for my aroids, a little bit more of a barky mixture because that's what the roots of this plant wants. But since this plant still wants to be a little bit more on the moist side, I go ahead and I add some sphagnum moss into that mix. So that's something that I learned on social media that has definitely been a prime factor as to why my houseplant has been looking so incredible. So also something I really enjoy about this houseplant is how it really matures without having to grow too much outside the planter, and that's because this houseplant stays inside the planter, and that's something I really enjoy about it. So this is a little bit different than many of the other philodendrons that we're used to seeing on the market. If you watch any of my houseplant tours here on YouTube, you're probably going to see that I grow a lot of my philodendrons and other aroids up a support. Maybe it's a moss pole or just a bamboo stick, or maybe it's a trellis on my wall. And as those grow up higher on the trellis, they really start to mature. And they'll get some different shape to their leaves, or ontogeny is the word. So that's something that is really interesting about climbing philodendrons. However, this is a creeping philodendron, so it's a little bit different than those. Whereas this philodendron is not going to leave the planter. It's not even going to just creep over the edge of the planter. So where I'm going with this is basically how this houseplant will only be creeping along the soil till a certain point. And in these planters, it's a finite space. If they were growing in the wild, they would have just endless space to continue creeping along the ground. However, in our homes, when we grow them in these planters, they eventually reach a point where they have hit the wall of the planter, and that is where I personally start to find some issues with this houseplant. So if I am not proactive enough maybe it's repotting this houseplant or propagating it. We'll get there in a moment. What will happen with this houseplant is as a new leaf is forming, it'll kind of get stuck and perhaps it'll snap at the petiole or just kind of practically suffocate itself in a way. So that is something that you do have to be a little bit more mindful of. So I mentioned I purchased this in the 4-inch pot like 2 or 3 years ago, and now it's in this large like 10, 11 inch planter. Most philodendrons I am not up potting that quickly. However, this one really seems to need that setting in order to thrive. You could plant it in like a rectangular trough shaped planter. That doesn't really fit the aesthetics of my home, but if that works for you, that is an excellent idea to work with this houseplant. But what I find myself doing is just constantly propagating this houseplant once it reaches the edge of the planter. And the fortunate thing about this type of philodendron, as it is a creeping philodendron, it's constantly rooting into the ground as it's creeping along the ground. Similar to how if you are growing a houseplant up a moss pole, it might start to root slightly into the moss pole. However, this roots aggressively into the soil. So if you have a decent plant that's maybe like a 6-inch of a stem and you want to go ahead and propagate maybe like 2 inches of the newest part of that stem, if you go ahead and cut it with a sharp knife or shears, it's already going to be rooted into the ground. So you will have to carefully go inside the soil and like separate the roots and the plant to move it to another area in the planter, or just take out the whole thing, propagate a couple sections and pot them all up together. There's a couple different ways that you could go about this. Perhaps I will do it in a video at some point, as that is something I'm going to have to tackle with this houseplant soon, as I do notice it's really starting to reach the edge of the planter over here when you see this new leaf that's coming out right there. So something you do need to be mindful of, but this houseplant is extremely rewarding and easy to propagate because when you propagate it, you don't even have to root your houseplant. It's already ready to go. And of course, here comes Muffin, who wants some attention, as it's going to seem is going to be when I'm filming these videos at the counter. Oh, hello, sweet pea. Speaking of Muffin, so this houseplant is not non-toxic. It is, I would say, mildly to moderately toxic, where my pet doesn't bother my houseplants. You'll see she just kind of like sniffs them and likes to play with her tail around them. So I'm not concerned about Muffin chewing on my houseplants. However, if you do have a pet or a child that you're worried about chewing on this plant, it is something I would be worried about because it does have oxalates in the leaves, which will cause some problems with their tongue. It'll make their mouth swell and their stomachs won't react well to it. So just something to be mindful of, but it's something that I don't worry about with my cat because this is not a fatally toxic plant. As far as pests with this houseplant, it's generally pest-free, which is great because these leaves are decently thin. However, the new leaves, I will notice, get some spider mites every now and again, which is just maybe an issue that I have in my home. However, I will just proactively wipe the new leaves with like a paper towel or a napkin that I've soaked in some rubbing alcohol and just proactively wipe it away to just not only clean the houseplant leaves, but keep them pest-free. So that is an excellent thing to do there as well. Humidity with this houseplant, it is best to maybe keep it in a higher humidity setting when you are first bringing it home, as this is probably grown in prime conditions, like a greenhouse where it's receiving higher humidity and the exact lighting that it requires to look as beautiful and full as it likely is when you are purchasing it. But I can happily report that after it has acclimated to your home for a couple of years, I have been treating this houseplant just like every other Dracaena and Aglaonema and standard philodendron that I have in my home, that I really don't need to pay any extra mind to it. I just go ahead, keep the leaves clean as much as I can, and keep the soil on the moist side. But besides that, this plant has been really rewarding to grow, as you can clearly see. It's really taking up a lot of space now, and I really love the presence that it has in my home and the way that these leaves are really just practically luminescent. It really is quite something. I totally understand, like I said, why this houseplant has gained so much popularity over the years. So I think that's going to wrap it up for today's video, how to care for Philodendron gloriosum, such a glorious houseplant. Like I said, the name truly says it all, so I totally understand the hype around this houseplant. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. If you don't already, follow me on Instagram @PhillyFoliage, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Have a great day!